Hello everybody, welcome to Brainy Dental. Let's begin with our tutorial. Now this is an extracted maxillary central incisor. Now this incisor, it has a length of about 22.8 millimeter. And we have a labial surface, this is our lingual surface. On the lingual surface we have cingulum, and we make our access cavity at a point just above the cingulum. The access cavity is triangular in shape. It is placed in the center of the tooth, and you must realize it is prepared right above the pulp chamber. So the shape of your pulp chamber follows basically the shape of the crown of the tooth. Now how do we locate the exact point where we want to start the access cavity? For this purpose, we divide the tooth into three parts by drawing two horizontal lines in this manner. So we have divided into incisal 1/3, middle 1/3 and cervical 1/3. Similarly, we draw two vertical lines in this way. Like this and like this. This is the pattern that we obtain. Now the pulp chamber lies in the middle box. And we make the access cavity here, which is triangular in shape, base of the triangle and the incisal edge, and apex towards the cingulum. Our point of entry is just above the cingulum, roughly here. This is the point that we have marked. I'm going to use two basic burrs, the round burr and the straight burr, to prepare the access cavity. We begin with the round burr. We position it perpendicular to the lingual surface of the tooth and we start our cutting. In this manner, we penetrate the enamel with a round burr. We have made a notch in the enamel, and now we will change the position of the burr and we will hold it parallel to the long axis of the tooth. In this way, we will enter straight into the pulp chamber and we will avoid any type of perforation. The burr is directed along the long axis of the tooth until the pulp chamber is reached. This way the cutting is done with in and out motion. Now how do we know that the pulp chamber is reached? Well, you'll feel a drop of the burr into the chamber once we reach there. An endodontic explorer is used to locate the canal orifice. Once the orifice is located, then we can use a file. I have used a 15 number file to enter through the orifice into the root canal. See, it has easily entered. Normally the root canal of a central incisor is large, simple in outline, conical in shape, and it is centrally located. You can see the file has come out through the apical foramen. I will use a straight burr to give proper shape to the access cavity. You see, our purpose here is to completely de-roof the pulp chamber so that we are able to remove all the pulpal remnants from the crown portion of the tooth. Now at this stage, it is important for you to know that the shape of your pulp chamber usually follows the contours of the crown. And in this case, our pulp has three pulp horns which correspond to the developmental mammillions of the young tooth. Now as we proceed with our cutting, you can see we have roughly assumed a triangular shape. Now we will remove all the overhanging enamel or dentine that may be present, and we move from inside to outside motion. Now this procedure makes your access cavity walls confluent with the lateral and the incisal walls of the pulp chamber. And this allows the access cavity to be in straight line to the root canal. This is how we complete our access cavity preparation, achieving a straight line access to our root canals. The first problem we'll discuss is inadequate opening or a small opening. Now, when the opening is very small, the main problem you will face is that a straight line access into the root canal orifice will be difficult. Secondly, when the opening is too small, that means there are some pulpar remnants still present within the pulp chamber. So they will discolor, which will cause discoloration of the crown. Also, when your opening is too small, achieving good obturation will also turn out to be a problem. The next is excessive tooth cutting. Now, very obviously, this will result in excessive removal of the coronal tooth structure, weakening the tooth and ultimately leading to a coronal fracture. Next is inadequate caries removal. Now this would result in future caries destruction and also discoloration of the crown. So we should be careful to inspect the crown structure after our access cavity preparation so that there are no caries remnants present. Next is gouging. Now this occurs if the direction of the burr is not correct. That means it is not directed parallel to the long axis of the tooth after initial penetration. Labial perforation. Now this occurs if gouging is not controlled. Now labial perforation, it can result in permanent disfigurement of the crown. Also it results in periodontal destruction. It can be easily controlled if the direction of the burr is changed after initial penetration. So you should be careful on that aspect. I hope you enjoyed your tutorial. And if you're going to make the access cavity for the first time, then all the best. Do like this video, share it with your friends, and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.